Hello, beautiful people. So this is my second video on the Jordan Peterson 12 rules sort of synopsis plus exercises. So the last video I mentioned an author, her name is Julia Cameron, and this is called The Artist's Way, whereby you go on artist dates and you journal your experiences by going through the artist dates throughout the week. I want to combine these ideas with the 12 rules so that we can integrate Jordan Peterson's 12 rules and better memorize them so that it doesn't become simply a book that we read and put aside and forget the principles, but something that we can integrate over weeks, months, years if we need to. So I want to read a small exercise plan and some small ideas for chapter 2, which is treat yourself like someone you are responsible for helping. As I have mentioned, in these few videos, we will gloss over Jordan Peterson's 12 rules while at the same time taking ourselves on an artist date or a lobster date. Here is some ideas I have for you that were inspired by chapter 2, treat yourself like someone you were responsible for helping. I was dating a girl at some point and she was worried very much about her dog. She would try and feed him well and take good care of him, but when it came time to take care of herself, she would get completely drunk, eat some of the worst food, and barely sleep. So how would you treat yourself if you were someone that you needed to care for? Not just someone that you needed to care for or were responsible for, but in fact, someone that you wanted to care for and somebody that you wanted to help. Carl Jung said, if you ask yourself the right questions, your mind will come up with some pretty ingenious answers. Example, if you are having a hard time solving a problem and you mull it over in your mind for a while, some pretty original and helpful answers will arise. Maybe even more than just helpful answers, some pretty genius information can spawn to the surface of your mind that you can use to solve your problems and enjoy a better life. I have gone a little further than simply asking myself questions. I have actually created a dialogue between me and, let's say, an alternate version of me. Example, kind of like an author tries to come to a conclusion between some of his characters, using each of the characters to display a version of the argument at hand, till the best resolution is brought forth. Napoleon Hill, author of the book Think and Grow Rich, literally used to imagine a conference table between Abraham Lincoln, Ralph Waldo Emerson, and Napoleon Hill, and Napoleon Bonaparte, amongst other brilliant figures, and got so involved in imagining them that he literally thought they were speaking to him at some point and derived some useful information from his imaginary characters. I don't want you to go that far unless you want to. All I ask is that you create a third party as part of your mental discourse to challenge your thoughts when you are not appearing to when they are not appearing to serve you. So I'm going to repeat that. I don't want you to go that far unless you want to. All I ask is that you create a third party as part of your mental discourse to challenge your thoughts when they are not appearing to serve you. Essentially, you are creating a grandmaster or a motivator in your mind to help you get through your life and through your situations. Example, if I say to myself that I am useless, I may ask the third party in me to disprove that it is true by confirming things that I have achieved and reminding me of people I have helped and projects that I have completed successfully, however small. I can literally turn this third party into my motivator, my personal Mr. Miyagi. Have a third party tell you all the things that you have been meaning to hear. Example, you are beautiful, you are worthy, you are talented, etc. Please don't have this third party voice compliment you into compliance and laziness. I think it's a tactic you should use to motivate you into higher spectrums of life and not as a means to feel good with yourself about doing nothing. It's not a system to create a cocky, useless version of yourself, more a process of creating a helpful, a helping hand that will get you to aspire a new to new heights as you stay humble. Also, I want you to trace back, if possible, where some of your negative narrative in your mind comes from. Maybe your dad told you you couldn't draw, and so you embodied the idea even though you never gave yourself the adequate time to develop the skills. Maybe someone was jealous of you and told you that you are ugly or fat, so you never inhabited your body as someone beautiful and worth being happy in your skin. To treat yourself well, you must look at why you are treating yourself poorly. Whose affirmations are you trying to prove right? Move from that if it isn't working and has you treating yourself as less than subpar. Your Grandmaster Lobster exercises for this chapter are: trace back some of the negative views you have about yourself and see if you can take small steps and create a small daily routine to disprove these damaging views. Number two, do a small gesture towards yourself that proves that you love and are loving towards yourself. Example, eat well, go for a long walk, meditate, simply treat yourself nice and with care. Number three, take down your negative views by asking the right questions about the present existing problems. Simply do not loathe the negativity, but legitimately try to come up with clever and novel solutions and responses to lingering internal problems. Number four, do an activity that you know you love to do that someone disapproved of or was condescending towards, and have no expectations about your performance of it. Simply do it out of love and to drive joy from your experience. Number five, this will come out often in our quest to improve ourselves using the 12 rules. Write a small passage daily of your progress or things that come up to the surface, however uncomfortable, and do so with as little judgment as possible. I have not outlined the amount of lines or pages I want you to write. Write as little or as much as you want, as long as you're getting something out of it and it's helping you to piece together some of the ideas that will improve your life and discard some of the ideas that are not working. Number six, last one. Eat at least one fruit and or vegetable this week you know you haven't eaten in a while, and maybe learn a healthy meal or recipe you can prepare for you and your loved ones. If you eat right, it eases some of the anxiety we face. I will speak more on this further along on our path together. God bless, lobsters, and namaste.